The next section is the core exercises. A strong core helps you to keep a good posture while running. This will help you to channelize your energy better in a more effective manner and therefore will improve your stamina and improve your performance. A strong core also helps you to be light on your feet and carries the weight of the body, thereby reducing the pressure on the joints, especially the knees and the ankle. So let's get on to the core exercises. But before that, I would like to show you what is called as a neutral spine. So we stand with our feet hip width apart, that is feet parallel. The insides of the feet are parallel to each other. Your spine is neutral and your shoulders are relaxed. Now, and knees are soft. Now tilt the pelvis forward and backward in this manner. Try to explore the entire range of motion in forward and backward manner. Make sure your upper body does not move along with your lower back. You just want to move the pelvis. Now, find a center point, not too front and not too much at the back, and find your center. This is called as a neutral spine. Now, let's get on to the core exercises. For this, the first exercise is called the plank. For this, you bend your elbows and lie down on the mat in this manner. Make sure the elbows are right below the shoulders. Now, keep the core gently active and raise your hip parallel to the floor and hold this position for any time between 15, 30 or 1 minute. And hold this position for any time between 15 to 30 seconds or 1 minute. Make sure your hip doesn't dip as the time passes. You have to keep the core strong and keep the spine neutral. Now, the second exercise is where you push your glutes right above in this manner. So, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Make sure from the neck till the lower back, the body is in one plank. Do this 15 times. This tones the glutes, the upper body, as well as the core muscles. Exhale, inhale. Now the third exercise is to be done in the full plank position. So come up in the starting position of a push-up. Again, make sure the spine is neutral. So you're not arching your back in this manner or curving it in this manner. Neutral position. And lift one knee and try to tuck it as close to the chest as possible. Make sure the hip is parallel to the floor, not going up and not sinking down. And hold this position for 10 seconds. And change the leg. Make sure you're breathing only with your nose throughout and gently keeping the core active. And now the fourth exercise is in the same position, but which we call as the spider plank, where you take your knees to the side and hold it. Make sure both the hips are pointing downwards and change the side. And now the fifth exercise is the reverse plank, where you put your feet in front of you, hands slightly behind your buttocks and palms and fingers facing forward. And inhale here, and as you exhale, push up your hips. Keep the core activated and make sure your hip doesn't sink down as time passes. Relax the neck completely. Again, you can hold this for any time between 15 to 30 seconds or 1 minute as per your capability. The next exercise is called the pikes. So you raise your legs in a V manner and your hands by your sides, and engage your core so that your back is not arching, and you're going to take the knees close to your chest and push them out. Keep the shoulder blades connected to the back and relaxed. You don't want to round them in this manner. Stay straight and keep the chest open. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Do these between 15 to 20 times. Next exercise is called the leg raises, where you lie down on the mat, hands by your sides and shoulder blades on the mat. Now raise both the feet together and make sure the lower back touches the mat in this position. Now lower both the legs and control the lower back from arching using your lower abdomen. Exhale and inhale. Keep the range of motion really small till you feel you're strong enough to prevent the lower back from arching. Exhale, inhale. Do 10 or 15 of these. Bring the knees together and hug them to stretch your lower back. And do a complete body stretch by flexing the heels and pushing the palms out. And do the complete inverse by taking the palms in and pointing your toes. So that concludes our core section.